Hi guys, welcome back. Well, that's, I say welcome back, that's if you've like actually watched the first one. I'm going to do part two of the Katana soundbar. I've got it all set up now and I've been using it for roughly about a month or so, and I just thought I'd give you a second viewing of it all set up and looking and show you what's what with it. So, I shall, well, I'll let you see it.
That's a joy for you. So there it is, all doing what it should do. You do get a dinky little remote as well with it, which is pretty cool to be fair. And that's my keyboard, I just thought I'd show you that because it's there. So you've got the LED different displays which you can put on it. That's solar orange, that's not really coming out that well because of the light in here. Then you've got Aurora, lights are off. That's the Wave Ice, that's like Night Rider. And that's the rainbow. I do quite like the rainbow one, to be honest. You can also mess around in the Sound Blaster Connect app thing, you know, just to change everything over, all the different colours, so you can basically have whatever colours you want going across this thing, but for me this one will do for now. I'll play you a bit of music, a bit of Harry Styles. Yeah, that's only on quite low, that's only on number 6. Oh, hang on, I'll show you the subwoofer as well. That's up to 8 now. You also have different sound things, so that's cinema, that's a night one, that's more neutral, that's gaming, that's concert, and that's cinema. So basically you could sort of hopefully hear the differences in sound then. Like I say, it is, I do quite like it to be fair, the sound is pretty cool. There's no way I could have it blasting out full blast. Well, I could, but my neighbours would be well impressed. And the colours scheme and things when it's lighting up is quite impressive. The one thing I would say is that it does collect quite a bit of dust, and as I live in a world where I have quite a bit of dust, then be warned that you could end up like just sort of giving it a dust down pretty much every day. Right, so that's basically it, guys.
So basically, overall impressions. Yeah, if you're after a soundbar, I'd pretty much recommend it. It's real cool, good addition to your system. Looks sensational, it's sexy as hell. And if you want something to annoy the neighbours, that is the thing to be buying, in my view. If you're listening to MP3s and just basically want it for streaming, like from your phone, then I probably wouldn't buy it, because you may as well just go to Poundland and buy a pair of speakers what are good enough for like MP3s nowadays. You will notice a difference streaming high-res music, so say goodbye to Spotify, say hello to Tidal or Cubus or something like that. But it is worth the purchase price, I'd say. Maybe slightly expensive, but the prices will come down, and obviously it's actually people who are just aiming for decent sound who are going to buy this. I've never actually hooked it up to an Xbox or anything like that. You can do that through an optical. But I could imagine that if you want it for that purpose as well, it would be well worthwhile considering, because it will just fully immerse your room in sort of sound, and games wise I can imagine that could be quite good for some game fans. Anyway, I shall leave you with that thought. Well, I don't know what thought that was actually. I could actually leave you with a thought. Oh, no, I couldn't, because I can't actually think of any. Right, take care, guys, and I shall no doubt do another review pretty soon. Not quite sure when, maybe over the next couple of weeks. Don't know if it'll be an unboxing. Don't know if it'll be an unboxing, it might just be a... We'll have a chat. So, I've got a billion opinions on loads of different subjects, so there's loads I can have a rant on about at some point. Right, have fun, guys. Take care. Speak to you soon. Bye.